Grabbed a full, sealed, unopened bottle of liquor. Cracked it open. You'll actually hear the plastic seal break.
You told Officer Muth that the bottle was open?
I don't remember my exact phrasing. I don't remember the exact placement. I don't remember the conversation.
本视频素材由 Our Tallahassee 提供，频道链接在视频下方。观众朋友们，大家好，欢迎来到紧张时刻。2023年5月7日凌晨2点左右，佛罗里达州塔拉哈西警局的警员在日常巡逻时发现一辆奔驰轿车的车灯没有打开，于是亮起警灯将其拦停。
Hello, sir. I'm Officer Oliver with Tallahassee Police Department. Do you have your driver's license, registration, insurance?
Is the reason why you slowed me down?
Yes, sir. So you don't have any headlights on, and you're going really fast on Monroe Street.
Headlight? My headlights automatically on when I'm driving.
They're not on right now.
Are you sure about that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. No problem. Because
where are you coming from?
I'm coming from 429 West Brevard Street. One of them is my brother.
Okay.
My name is Kevin Riley Sr.
Okay. Do you have a driver's license?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Can you get that for me?
I can't find it right now.
Where's your wallet at?
I don't really carry a wallet.
You don't carry a wallet at all?
Yeah.
Where do you carry your money at?
Bank.
A bank? Okay. How do you pay for things? On your phone?
男子此时得意地表示自己平时付款都是用手机电子支付。要知道，在美国，现金和信用卡仍是主流的支付方式。
Okay, I got you. No problem, I'll write down your information. You said Calvin Riley? I can take that. Perfect. Senior?
Yes.
What's your date of birth, sir?
April 3rd, 1968.
April 3rd, 1968. Okay. So I'll just want to go ahead and show you. So right now you just have your parking lights on. So if you switch them to, that's your auto. Now they're on.
Okay.
Sit tight for me, okay? You said April 3rd of
1968?
Okay. Thank you. Give me 1 second.
警员回到警车内对卡尔文的身份信息进行进一步核实，最后发现卡尔文的驾照已经被吊销。在佛罗里达州，用吊销的驾照行车是一项轻罪，初犯是二级轻罪，可导致至高$500的罚款和至多60天的监禁。司机初犯时，将由警员自行决定是否对司机进行逮捕。然而，如果警员发现司机除此之外还有其他的违法行为，则必须将其逮捕。另一名同伴此时又怀疑卡尔文酒驾，询问其是否愿意进行酒精清醒测试。
No. Okay. Here, go ahead and step out of the vehicle for us. Just go ahead and finish the car for us. Your license is suspended, so we're gonna.
Okay. No problem.Oh, should I call somebody to come pick my car?
Yeah, we'll get to that. Just give me a second, okay?
And my license.
You knew your license was suspended?
No, I didn't.
That's why you didn't have your ID on you.
First of all, my ID is at my job.
在佛罗里达州，警员会根据对司机的观察，诸如其说话是否含糊不清、眼睛是否充血、眼神是否呆滞、身上是否有酒味等信息，来判断司机是否涉嫌酒后驾车。在最终逮捕司机前，警员会询问司机是否愿意进行酒精清醒测试。通常，警员会向司机解释，这项测试是司机可以向警员证明自己没有酒驾的一次机会。法律规定，如果司机拒绝此项测试，并不会直接导致被逮捕，也不能用于法庭起诉的证据。但是，警员会直接根据自己先前的观察来确定是否逮捕司机。
Mr. Riley, I have a quick question for you. So I smelled in your vehicle. Did you recently?
Let me tell you something, ma'am. Let me tell you something. I don't know.
此时，警员又询问卡尔文是否服用了违禁品，卡尔文是连忙否认。然而，一旦警员怀疑司机持有违禁品，那么基于正当理由原则，警员将可以不用等待司机的允许，直接对其车辆进行搜查。
It smells very strong. This is cologne right here, though. It's like sprayed it like right before. Okay, nothing in there.Hey, there's vodka in his seat, like right here in a pouch in his seat. Vodka was found in this pouch in his seat.
在警员对卡尔文的车辆进行了彻底的搜查后，并未发现任何违禁品。但是驾驶座的附近，警员发现了一小瓶伏特加。好家伙，警员转身看了一圈后，突然拿起那瓶还未开封的伏特加，直接将瓶盖拧开，将里面的伏特加倒在了路边。我们再来看下半镜头，在这里我们可以明显听到瓶盖密封条被扯开的声音。随后，警员熟练地将空了的伏特加瓶扔到了副驾驶位。佛罗里达州法律规定，在行驶的车辆内不得出现开封的酒精饮料，包括司机和乘客均不得在车内饮酒。警员随后又向同伴告知了在驾驶位的下方发现了伏特加酒瓶。
No, so he has a cover on his seat, and in the cover where like the knee would sit, there's an opening, and he had it.
随后，警员又向后来赶到现场的警司谎称在卡尔文的车辆内发现了已经开封的酒瓶。随后，警司和警员在讨论卡尔文的案情时，竟然互相询问对方的执法记录仪是否已经关闭。随后，警员的执法记录仪也被关闭。此次执法的警员名为奥利弗。奥利弗在随后的逮捕报告中说道，在卡尔文的车辆中发现了一小瓶已经开封的伏特加，放在了驾驶位一侧。在法庭上，卡尔文的律师当庭指出了奥利弗警员在执法时故意进行栽赃陷害。
Officer Oliver reaches in Calvin Riley's vehicle, grabbed a full, sealed.Unopened bottle of liquor, cracked it open. You'll actually hear the plastic seal break. It is a distinct sound. You're going to see it from the angle of her own body camera. She was too brazen to even bother turning it off. She then pours out some, but not all, the liquid, puts the cap back on, and then tosses the bottle back into his vehicle.
卡尔文的律师向法官表示。奥利弗警员严重违规执法，应当撤销当事人卡尔文的指控。法官直接当庭拒绝了律师的请求，而佛罗里达州公诉方这样说道
See, you're going to learn throughout today's trial that impairment isn't necessarily falling on the floor drunk or tipping over, struggling to walk. It can be something as simple as your vision is affected when I take my glasses off. It can be as something as simple as not being able to follow instructions, struggling to find documents. It can be something as simple as slurring your words.
奥利弗警员本人也在法庭上承认了自己将卡尔文的酒瓶开封并且倾倒，但是表示那是因为自己以为警局有政策不允许警员将液体搜集为证据归档，而实际情况是警局根本没有这一政策。在交叉质询环节，奥利弗警员瞬间变成了失忆大师。
Was he cursing during this period of time?
I don't remember.
His left blinker was on, is that correct?
I don't remember.
Which was the registration for his car, correct?
I don't remember.
Because the car had automatic lights.
I don't remember if it had an auto setting.
It was a strong odor.
It wasn't strong, but I couldn't remember smelling it.
Vehicle?
I don't remember if she searched the vehicle.
So you don't remember her searching on the passenger side while you searched on the driver's side?
No, I don't remember that.
You told Officer Muth that the bottle was open?
I don't remember my exact phrasing.
You can just show me
Objection,
where it's
recording. Improper impeachment.
Do you not remember?
I don't remember the exact placement. I don't remember what my thought process was behind the statement. I don't remember the conversation.
So you don't remember discussing indicators impairment that you saw in Mr. Riley?
I don't remember discussing that, no.
Did Officer Muth or Sergeant Smith ever convey you that their body-worn camera was on after you had turned yours off?
I don't remember that. I don't remember.
Yeah, have you previously testified that the protocol is to dump out open containers?
I don't remember.
令人大跌眼镜的是，事后塔拉哈西警局的局长居然也力挺奥利弗警员，认为其没有过错。此段执法记录仪一经公开，立即引起了轩然大波。众多网友表示，像奥利弗这种故意栽赃陷害的警员就应该立即关进监狱。作为一名佩戴警徽和警枪的执法人员，居然还对平民百姓故意栽赃陷害，这种行为的危害性极大，对社区造成的影响极其恶劣。还有网友表示，最后包括警司在内的几名警员互相让对方关闭执法记录仪的行为属实令人作呕啊！所有故意关闭静音执法记录仪的行为都应当直接按篡改证据罪论处，严重影响了司法的公正性。观众朋友们，你们对此案又有什么样的看法呢？请在评论区留言。另外，如果观众朋友们有什么视频想让我们做成影片分享给大家，请通过下方的谷歌表格提交网址或者视频。我们下期轩然大波再见。